Now Manuel. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups. And they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
And this will probably be the last play of the quarter.
Third and five, so they bring in an extra defensive back.
Expecting pass. Here's Manuel. And Tate's got it. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. Here with Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, as the Lions are in possession of the football here to begin quarter number two. And they've got it here with a first down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. It's brought in left side by Tate. It's a gain of 17 that time. And the Lions are going to have a first.
Well, for teams that like to play man coverage, running corner routes can be tough on them because of the ability of getting into it. Sometimes you're squaring it off. Sometimes you're just rounding it. Sometimes there's a fake. Sometimes there's not. It makes it very, very difficult for a DB to stay with it.
A gain of three, second down.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Second down following the run. Now back to throw. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. It's a gain of five on the play. And all of a sudden here, it's third down.
Granted, more and more offenses are going to the philosophy of using every inch of the field to try and spread things out. And when you're running back and catch the ball as well, that can only help your offense.
So completion on second down, that brings up third. Back to throw, and that is incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So it goes down as an 8-play drive, and they cap it with the field goal.
Yeah, they were able to pick up a few first downs along the way, but they couldn't keep the momentum going all the way into the end zone.
Penalty marker is down here. And a nice return sets them up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Let's go!
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And he's got his man in stride, complete. They'll get 23 yards there. And that leads to a Green Bay first. They try the corner route there, Charles, and it works to perfection.
Boy, that's hard on a defensive back because if you get any faker move to the inside, you have to respect it, and then the receiver breaks back to the sideline.
First down, here's a run with Peterson. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. And the offense behind the chains here, a touch on second and 11.
Let's go!
Back to throw here. He's going to get this one out to his fullback. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it third and one.
I think the good offensive coordinators of the league now are looking at the fullback position and finding the right guys to hide in that spot and increase their passing game, as we just saw there. How about the run after catch? Racked him.
Well, yeah, whether it's a true fullback, a tight end you put in the fullback spot, you know they're going to be tough to bring down if you can get them the football in the passing game.
They'll run it now out of the gun. The gain of four that time as the drive continues.
Everyone understood their role on that play. Third and one, you know the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive lineman, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed them to get through for a first down.
They'll set up to throw, buying time to his left. It's brought in by Janis. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
So here we go, first and 10 now.
He'll drop to throw. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. Nothing on that one. It'll be second down.
So many screen passes are the result of excellent acting by everyone. But sometimes the guy who's getting the ball tips the play off. The running back, because he's eager to get the pass. And sometimes he doesn't act very well about whether he's going to block or leak out or whatever. And I think that they saw that. And that's why they're able to get to him on it.
To throw now on second and 10. His throw incomplete. Jordan Matthews, the one he was looking for. And it'll be third and 10.
The goal of anyone running a curl route is to make sure you try and get defenders on your back and shield them away from the football. But sometimes, even when you run a good route, the defense finds a way to knock it away.
Now play number 7 of the drive as they're looking at a third and 10. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And try to get it to his tight end, Rodgers, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And he's able to get it back to the 33-yard line. And Detroit getting set to go now. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want it to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that. They weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants a drive to end with a kick, other than the extra point. That's it.
Now Manuel. And break, the tight end's got it. It'll be a gain of 6, and that's going to lead to a third down.
And there's a completion to the tight end, and look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
And this is going to be incomplete.
Well, that was pretty nice to watch if you like a defense's perspective, because they understood where the first down line was as much as the offensive guys did. Did not give up any more ground. And when the ball...
And how about this? A fake. Wide open receiver complete. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line.
The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's get back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better. When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
They'll look to throw now on first down, and that'll be incomplete.
And now we're circling here around the 2-minute warning.
This is a setup play, trying to get one last one in before the clock running.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. It gets it over the middle to Cobb. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Lambeau following these words. And the Lions going with an extra DB here on third down. A
Again, he'll drop the throw. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped. Altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it. And now fourth down. Now Mason Crosby for the Packers field goal try. This from 54 yards away. And Crosby kicks it through. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So a little fortunate there because that one was definitely leaking right.
Without a doubt. Maybe about the width of a football or so inside that right upright. But he got it to go.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Lions offense, they get ready to head back onto the field. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief though when they only gave up the field goal and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive? A little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown. But they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
Well, Coach will just be relieved though if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think Coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield, punching the end zone without turning it over. It is hard in zone coverage to stop a curl route because when they see it, they just try and find the open spot and sit down.
Yeah, we always talk about finding the soft spot in the zone. What's the key to doing that? How do you do it?
You have to read what the coverage is. Is it too deep? Is it three deep? Because then you know where the linebackers are going to drop, what spots on the field they naturally get to, and you find that open space, and then you're in sync with your quarterback. He should be reading the exact same thing, and they put the ball right on you.
Here's Manuel. Eluding the pressure right. And he'll just chuck this one up into row G. It's incomplete.
Different pass rushes are designed for different things. Sometimes you want to keep the quarterback in the pocket. Sometimes you want him to flush. I don't know exactly how this one was designed, but they made sure they moved him to his right. He got out of the pocket. Unfortunately for him, he was hit as he tried to throw the ball, and that resulted in an incompletion.
Over the middle, complete to Tate. And he takes it down deep into Green Bay territory. A big play there for Detroit. 53 yards. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this, but run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position. After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it in the end zone, a big time drop.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Stepping up, he's going to keep it, and he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup, and that is going to set up third and goal.
Well, he did a nice job keeping his eyes downfield, waiting for someone to get open. But once the pressure forced his eyes down to see the rush, it was time to make a break for it.
This defense hasn't let him in yet. They'll need to stiffen here. Third and goal from the two. They come out here in the eye. Fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because This is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And Prater's kick is on the money. It's good. And the drive will wind up yielding 3. So a field goal here, they're still down, but they put a dent into that lead before the break.
And that's got to feel good because now they've seen that they can put some more points on the board, and that gives them a whole second half to get back to where they want to be, and that's in the lead.
And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. So we're at halftime here at Lambeau with the Packers taking the lead to the break. As we'll send you down to Orlando, where Larry Ridley has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry, both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. While he gets attended to, we'll step aside.
Here we go! Grand 38! Grand 38! Ohio! Ohio! Ohio!
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
And while that play was unsuccessful to start the second half, I'm not sure that you just totally abandon what you do running the football. Maybe you make some adjustments in your run game and do things a little bit differently, but that doesn't necessarily mean you just go to the pass and do nothing else.
Jeff Janis, the one he was looking for. And that'll bring up a third and 11 situation.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Offense needs 11. Have to think pass here on third down.
Let it go. 190.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. Open man, the tight end Rodgers. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 6 yards on the pickup, and it's a second down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And his throw here is incomplete. Matthews, the intended target, and it'll be second and 10. But pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. Give him 7 on the play, and that'll make it third down.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about 3 different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
He's got his target. It's Cobb. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
And fits the exact right word. Over the middle, there's almost always traffic, so anytime you're a receiver in that area, you're not just focused on catching the football. You're wondering where the collision's going to come from, right? Because there's almost always someone there able to concentrate, catch it, and even added a little extra at the end with a short run.
A little bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11. Now they'll throw here out of the gun, being chased out left. And he's brought down. That one goes for 30. Yards and it moves the sticks. Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. They'll run it now out of the gun. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Sometimes play calls boil down to philosophy. Top 10 units against the run in the NFL. So do you decide to keep...
Morris fighting. He lost the football. And the Lions have recovered. A look at the offense now here coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the three-point...
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him at contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe.
Now the defense definitely showing blitz here. Now Manuel. Looking for Jones and it's intercepted. Picked off by Morgan Burnett and the return stops at the 39-yard line. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. Certainly they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone offense. I mean, you have periods devoted in practice just for that because everyone knows how vital it is to put points on the board when you've entered that part of the field. And to come away with nothing, that's difficult for a team to handle.
And difficult, and now we'll see if they can make it less difficult on themselves on this drive. And now inside the red zone, the offense will operate. They'll look to throw here on first down. And he whips that one incomplete there.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. A great play there. His third touchdown now on the year. And that interception key as it leads to the touchdown. It's good, and now it's an 11-point lead, 17-6. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. They come up in an offset eye. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down.
You know the key to a good screen pass is, don't you?
Bet you're going to tell me. Good blocking?
Well, good blocking eventually. But first, it's good acting. You want to let the defenders go past you, leak out to whichever side or even in the middle where you want to set up the screen, and then you do your blocking. How about the read, though, by the defensive?
Looking for Tate, and it's intercepted. And it's ha-ha Clinton Dix with a pick. And he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
If you love pressure,
we'll
see if they dial it up this drive. He'll drop to throw. Flush to his right. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide. It's a gain of six on the play, and that'll bring up a second and goal.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's maybe going to get this back to the four, but that's about all. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third. Line of scrimmage at the four. Here's third and goal. They'll look to throw on third and goal. Escaping the pressure right. Fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out. And this is scooped up by the Lions.
Well, give some credit to the defense. They forced the big play. Knocked the ball free from him. But that's a cardinal sin by the quarterback. Know where you are on the field. And he just gave up at a minimum 3 points.
And instead of getting down, takes the contact. The turnover ensues. It's brought in left side by Tate. A big play that time on the catch and... Run, 38 yards. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Here's Manuel. He's got time. Eluding the pressure right. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah. That stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but if the other team doesn't get it, that's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they're able to retain possession.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And break, the tight end's got it. And he's brought down. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do, you got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end, take some easier completions.
Yeah, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. And nearly picked off there, almost intercepted. Instead, second down.
I know that interception was dropped, and it would have been their third of the game. And I will guarantee you, in the huddle, on the bench, all the defensive guys have been talking about is, we've got this guy right where we want him. Who's going to get the next one? It almost becomes a challenge, and they missed a golden opportunity.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. And a really good gain there on the post route. Partner, how do you know to go to that pass?
When you're running the ball effectively and the safety likes to dive up there to try and help tackle, that's when you want to hit him over the top of the post in the area he vacates.
So the offense has it first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. That is caught, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Marvin Jones, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Lions have got it back to a one-score game. Now Matt Prater for the point after. And he bangs it through and makes it a 17-13 ball game. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this across the 25. A couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The Packers offense now heading back out onto the field. And so close to hitting pay dirt last time. Fumbling down near the goal line. Now, how does that affect their psyche this time around?
It's a tester, that's for sure, because to be that close and come away with no points is really disappointing, not just for the guys on offense, but the defensive players, too, who thought, hey, we're going to put some points up and have a little momentum going. They've got to find a way to just get it out of their minds, let it go,
short-term memory,
and move on to the next series.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. He makes a wonderful play there off the corner, protecting his side of the field.
Oh, that reminds me of the great defenses of old, doesn't it? The Pittsburgh Steelers' steel curtain. They would not let you get on the field if you could only do one thing. You had to be a complete guy, and you had to be able to tackle.
Now, I know I've said this before, but you know I wasn't alive when the steel curtain was playing. I know them, but I just want to let you know I wasn't alive.
I'm going to keep peppering that in there, and one of these days, you're going to think that you were.
So second and 10 here. They come out here in the eye. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. It'll go in the books as a 7-yard loss on the sack, and it's third down.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
And this will be caught at the 30. Touchdown, Packers. Their dangerous wide receiver, 79 yards. And the Packers add on to their lead. And there they got him the ball. Just get it to him, let him do the rest.
You know, he probably said that to his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Helping out his rack, right? RAC?
Run after catch. And he loves that, and he's going to carry that in at contract time.
This one taken from the 7. And Detroit getting set to go now. Last time they were out, they scored. Still trailing here, though, so some work to do.
But it's okay in terms of mindset. Because they scored the last time, they're not quite as worried about being down on the scoreboard because now their confidence is a little bit higher. They feel like they've got something going, and they feel like they can attack again and put more points on the board.
Are you scoreboard watching if you're the offense, or are you just focused on this drive?
We wouldn't be telling the truth if we said that they didn't scoreboard watch. Everyone does it to some extent, but you've got to set it aside right now and just focus on this series. That'll take care of the scoreboard if they punch it into the end zone. I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. Now Manuel, and it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. And a 2-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified, big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible. Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
Back to throw again, and he'll jack this one down to McCoy. And he'll go down at the 28. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
They'll look to throw now on first down. Steps away to his left. And down inside the 15 he goes. It's a pickup of 14 there, and it'll be first down Lions. And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. It's brought in left side by Tate. Give him 9 on the play, and it'll be second and about a yard. He's been a busy man here in this one, and they're showing off some nice footwork to stay in bounds.
And with those types of catches and the volume that we've seen in this game, wouldn't you keep him busy as well?
I would.
Of course. You got to keep throwing it to him. He keeps making plays.
Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. They'll try and sneak it here. They'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a 2nd and goal. And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series.
Hey, give him credit. That's a good sign.
And he's going to take it in for a Lion touchdown. E.J. Manuel with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Lions able to get this back within a touchdown. Prater on to add the extra point. And the lead is down to four. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Well, they went for the big play there, but really hurt their momentum.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. Touchdown, Packers! Jordan Matthews, his first touchdown on the year. And the Packers add six to their lead. And when a Hail Mary is completed for a touchdown pass like that, I think any defensive coordinator just puts their face right into their hands.
I don't think there's any doubt about it, and I don't have stats in front of me. I don't have the empirical numbers that say that in recent years the Hail Mary pass has been completed more than it has been, but it feels that way, doesn't it? And I know the defenses are spending more time on it. I think the biggest mistake they make is that they play everything from behind the receiver. I think they've got to start getting people in front as well to try and knock the ball away.
And Detroit getting set to go now. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
Here's Manuel. Flushed out right. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
They tried to make something happen, but that one came up incomplete and really wasn't a good-looking throw.
Yeah, maybe even go as far as to call that a little ill-advised.
Yeah, I would say so. I think that's the right phrase for it. Definitely ill-advised. Just wonder about his mechanics right now, you know, and that's the time.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. It'll be a sack and a loss of three, but more importantly, it brings up fourth down. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
Give him 28 yards on that one, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. Shift together here from the D-line. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
And his throw is going to be incomplete. The tight end, Cameron Brate, was the target. And that'll make it second and 10. Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Whenever I see an in route dropped, as we just saw in that play, I'm always thinking that in the back of their mind, they're worried about what's coming at them because they're going towards traffic on that route as opposed to being away from it and maybe having a little bit more space.
Here comes the seventh play now of this drive as this is third and 10. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Sam Shields.
Partner, we always talk about this.